Tonight, we have a nice surprise for you. We have a guest trumpet player. His name is Anthony Limoncelli. I think most of you will recognize him because he certainly played at the Church of the Redeemer quite a bit this past year. He was with the Sarasota Orchestra this year, but wonderful for him, unfortunate for us, he won the audition for the Atlanta Symphony Orchestra, principal second trumpet. So he will be leaving in August, so we're getting him just in time. So tonight, I decided that the specialty that we would present to you would be about music transcriptions. And so I'm sure many of you know what that is, but many of you probably don't, because there are medical transcriptions and business transcriptions and transcription apps, but there are also musical transcriptions. And the kind that I'm talking about are the kind that they're big orchestral pieces, like what we're doing tonight, Pictures at an Exhibition. The first piece is by a composer named Fasch. This is actually for trumpet and orchestra, but we're doing it for trumpet and organ. The Mazursky, Pictures at an Exhibition, which was set by, orchestrated by Ravel, is an unbelievable piece that was originally written for piano. And so, once again, a transcription. When I was in school, 1,000 years ago, the whole idea of transcription kind of taboo, sort of out of style. And I think it came really from the neoclassical period of, you know, resurgence of Bach and Stravinsky and Schoenberg and just a whole different attitude. But in the last, I don't know, 20, 25, maybe even 30 years, there's been a resurgency of transcription music for the organ. And so you're hearing it everywhere. And I have decided that it is an infinitely harder to play transcriptions for the organ than it is to play just the straight organ literature. So tonight, the only piece on the concert that is not a transcription piece is the Prayer of St. Gregory by Allan Hovhaness. Hovhaness was an Arminian lineage, although I think his father was from Turkey. Anyway, he was very much into a sort of Middle Eastern modal type of music, and you will hear that it is a piece for trumpet and for organ. But all the other pieces, the Fasch, the second piece, which is the Edward Elgar, Adagio from his Cello Concerto. It's one of my favorite movements of an orchestral piece in the whole world. And so I'm not quite sure the organ does it justice, but it's such a beautiful piece that it lives everywhere. It stands alone. And then the other organ piece, solo, that I will play tonight is the piece from Aida, the Grand March. And I don't have to really say anything about that. It's great for a wedding. It's great for a processional. It's a wonderful piece of music, and it goes really quite nicely on the organ. I think one of the reasons I'm so fond of it is because when I was 5 years old, the school that I went to had a May Day queen, and then they had little princesses, and I was a five-year-old princess, and it's one of my first memories. I had this really dressy dress, and we went around the Maypole. It was on May 1st, and the music that they played for us to process to was the Triumphal March from Aida. So I'm sure that everybody will recognize that. So sit back and have some champagne or whatever you want and enjoy the concert tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Anthony Limoncelli, and I want to thank you again for joining us from the comfort of your own home. For our last piece on the program, Anne and I will be playing an arrangement of Mussorgsky's Pictures at an exhibition. Now, usually I'm a little hesitant in choosing a piece not originally written for the trumpet to play on a trumpet recital, but this arrangement captures the integrity of the piece while giving a new perspective on this staple of the instrumental repertoire. Now, before we get started, I just wanted to say a few thank yous. I wanted to thank Anne Moe and the Church of the Redeemer for having me and for creating this sort of visual musical contact between me and you at your homes. It's really special that we share music at this time. I also want to thank the crew at Project Coffee for keeping me caffeinated during my various practice sessions and rehearsals. Now more than ever is a great time to support local business, and they are truly great people that you should give your support and patronage to. Finally, I want to thank my Sarasota Orchestra members and colleagues and friends. They've really been warm and welcoming during my time here, and I'll be sad to go, but I've made great memories with them, and I look forward to staying friends for the future. So thank you again for joining us, and I hope you enjoy Mussorgsky's Pictures at an Exhibition by Vincent DiMartino and Skylar Robinson.
Thank you.